Welcome to Alpha Online Education. Today, the civics first year English medium. In this civics act, the unit number 2, the topic is kinds of sovereignty. So actually, the sovereignty, two important questions in the side of the sovereignty. So one is features of sovereignty, one is features of sovereignty, and another is kinds of sovereignty. So one is characteristics or features of sovereignty, and then here the kinds of sovereignty. So the sovereignty, how many kinds to the side of sovereignty? The 7 kinds in the side of sovereignty. So these 7 are kinds of sovereignty. So the most important in these sovereignty side, so 2 questions are most important. So in these 2, the one is characteristics of sovereignty or the kinds of sovereignty. So these 2 questions are most important annual examinations questions. So here the kinds of sovereignty. So here the 7 kinds of sovereignty. The one is nominal sovereignty, and the second one is real sovereignty, and the third one is legal sovereignty, and the fourth one is political sovereignty, and the fifth one is popular sovereignty, the sixth de jure, the seventh de facto sovereignty. So these 7 are kinds of sovereignty. In this sign, the first one is nominal sovereignty. So actually, the here, what is meaning of sovereignty? And here the sovereignty means supreme power. So what is the, who maintain authority is sovereign. Who maintain authority? For example, the principal is old and so sovereign of the college. So in his side, the sovereignty. So the district collector, total sovereignty in hands of district. So he maintained his supreme power. So what is meaning of sovereignty? It is the sovereignty is a rule and order of sovereign. Sovereignty is rule and order of sovereign. So finally, please try to understand it. Who is sovereign? Who maintain authority? Is sovereign. Here he maintained full supreme power. So for example, the principal maintained supreme power, he is sovereign of the college. So the district collector is sovereign. So he is the district head. So the authority total in his side. So here the sovereignty means supreme power. So here the nominal sovereignty. Nominal means, for example, the authority in his name. So the powers of in his side is nominal. For example, the President of India. Example, President of India. Example, President of India. So actually the authority, the name, the Indian administration total in his name. So the authorities of in his side is nominal authorities. Example, President of India. So he maintain his nominal authorities. So the President of India, this is the first one. And the second one is real savarjan, real savarniti. So actually who maintain real authority is real savarjan. For example, Prime Minister of India. So actually he is real savarjan. He maintained his real sovereignty. The Prime Minister and his ministers all are real savarjans. So here the head of the ministers is Prime Minister. So the real savarjan, the real sovereignty is in the hands of Indian Prime Minister. So here the nominal sovereignty and the real sovereignty. The nominal sovereignty, best example, the President of India, the real sovereignty, best example, the Prime Minister of India. So, the legal sovereignty. So, the sovereignty is in total, the sovereignty is depends on law. The legal sovereignty. For example, the courts. So, the sovereignty, it is legal sovereignty. Who decides legal or illegal? The courts decides. So the legal sovereignty means according to law. Legal sovereignty means according to law. According to law is called legal sovereignty. So according to law, the sovereignty, that is the legal sovereignty. For example, courts. And the political sovereignty. So the political, the political sovereignty. So actually the political officials in political, they maintain these political sovereignty. So actually the political heads, the heads of the political, they have some power per their side. So the name of that authority is political sovereignty. Political sovereignty. And then the fifth one is popular sovereignty. So it is sovereignty totally in the hands of the people. Popular. So the popular sovereignty, who signs? The people signs. So actually the decided factor. So actually the sovereign is elected by, nominated by the people. So for example, the Prime Minister of India and Chief Minister of India, the Prime Minister of India and Chief Minister of the state. The Chief Ministers of the state, they are elected by the people. They are all elected by the people. So here the popular sovereignty means the people. So the participation of the people at the time of elections, if the people do not participate in elections, so the government do not consist. So the government is consisted by the people. The government is the final sovereign. So the popular sovereign total in hands of the people. So at the time of election, what the politician says, please give your valuable vote to me. So you give chance to sovereign. At the time they ask votes. At the time who asks votes? The politicians ask votes. At the time the people give their votes to those for the base of sovereignty. Okay? The elected candidates all are sovereigns. They are elected by the people. So the popular sovereignty is in hands of people. And then the de jure sovereignty, de jure and de facto. These two are most important 2 marks questions to the side of all first years. So what is meaning of de jure? What is meaning of de facto? So de jure based on law, de jure sovereignty based on law. So actually the law narrates important role. All sovereigns are in control of the law. The law decides. It is the factor of decide factor. So these de jure sovereignty total based on law. The de jure sovereignty total based on law, and then the de facto sovereignty based on authority. So don't confuse here. So the de jure, it is totally based on law. It is based on law. The de facto, it is based on authority. It is based on authority based law. Authority based. It is de facto based on law. It is de jure. So these seven are kinds of sovereignty. Nominal sovereignty, for example, president. Real sovereignty, example, Prime Minister of India. Legal sovereignty, it is totally in hands of the court. The political sovereignty, the sovereignty is in the hands of politicians. The sovereignty is in the hands of politicians or political heads. And then the popular sovereignty, it is total in hands of the people. It is total in hands of the people. And then the de jure sovereignty, it is based on law. The de facto sovereignty, it is based on authority. So these seven are kinds of sovereignty. Here another, so it is a very important 5 marks question, all first year students. It is John Austin theory. John Austin theory. So what is the meaning of John Austin theory? Ante, so he says in his voice, single sovereign, he give more priority to single sovereign. So here the single sovereign and popular and single sovereign one, and also second one is popular sovereign. So here the single sovereign, John Austin give more priority to single sovereign, only one man show. Single sovereign means one man show, and another is plural sovereignty. So actually John Austin wise, he give more priority to single sovereign. So only one man maintain total authority. The authority is in only one's hand. That is, according to John Austin, that sovereignty is better sovereignty of plural sovereignty. So it is actually John Austin give more priority to single sovereign and single sovereignty. So just like it is equal to dictatorism. So John Austin wise, so it is a very important question, what priority gives to, ante John Austin gives more priority to single persons theory. The name of that theory is John Austin's theory. So it is the voice of John Austin. And the second one is plural. So actually our Indian sovereignty is plural sovereignty. Plural sovereignty ante the sovereignty divides in various level. So in these single sovereign side, the authority is in total in hands of only one person or one sovereign. In plural side, the authority divides in various sectors. So this is the plural sovereignty. So finally, the John Austin gives more priority to single sovereign. The name of that theory is John Austin's theory. And then the second one is plural sovereignty. Plural